The Veterans Training Program starts with a three-month intensive in-class training, and that includes, you know, learning about hydroponic systems. It includes, you know, how do we grow mushrooms? What's all involved in that? How is that different from growing basil? So we also have built in there entrepreneurship. So how do you actually transition this skill set into a potential business on your own? And so they go through that formal training in the classroom, but then we couple that with the experiential learning here on the farm.
I've known Angie for a long time from my UMKC days. So when she came to me and kind of laid out this idea of taking residents from a residential program and utilizing them, giving them job training and, you know, building in this skill that's easily developed and can, again, set them up for long-term success, which is what we're all about, it was pretty much a no-brainer for me. You know, I said, we have the space to do it. We have the people to do it. UMKC has the know-how, so why don't we partner up and see what good we can do for the community?
As the daughter of a veteran myself, it's very, very important to me to be a strong ally for veterans, and I thought that this would be a really cool idea of how do we work within Kansas City to go out, reach our veterans that are here locally, and train them in what is to become a $100 billion industry by 2030.
I was in the National Guard. I was on tanks, M60 tank. When I transitioned to active duty, I went on the M1 Abrams tank. And the reason why I transitioned out of being on an armor crewman is because no one outside the military has got a need for that in their workforce.
A lot of those agricultural jobs are high-paying jobs. They're good jobs, and they're something that somebody can really build a career off of.
There is a huge demand for workforce and for training in controlled environment agriculture systems. So like we're in here today, right? We're in a container and we're actually gonna be able to be growing vegetables and produce in this indoor environment.
I wanna grow stuff. I do. I grew up in government subsidized low-income housing. People that are impoverished generally don't grow things for themselves in an urban environment. And so it's one of those things I was always curious about.
The goal isn't to just give somebody any sort of employment. It's about meaningful employment, something that somebody is going to really feel proud of doing that they can carry with them long term. And my experience at UMKC was very much that university is about Kansas City. It is about developing people to be great Kansas Cityans long term.
In some aspect, we're like little kids. We want to learn something new and do something that we haven't done before. All right, we've shot at people, we've been shot at, we've, you know, blown things up, or people tried to blow us up. Now can we grow something?